وبركاته
وعليكم
السلام. الحمد لله الذي أبدع الأفلاك والأرضين والصلاة والسلام على من كان نبيا وآدم بين الماء والطين وعلى آله وأصحابه الطيبين الطاهرين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم قال الله تبارك وتعالى في القرآن العظيم والفرقان الحميد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده ليلا من المسجد الحرام إلى المسجد الأقصى الذي باركنا حوله لنريه من آياتنا إنه هو السميع البصير صدق الله مولانا العظيم وبلغنا رسوله النبي الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما Everyone collectively recite the Sharif Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina wa Mawlana Muhammad wa ala ala Sayyidina wa Mawlana Muhammad wa barik wa sallim Sallu alayhi salatu wa salamun alayka ya Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayka wa sallam All praise due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who is our creator, provide the sustainer Durood and salam on the best of creation Sayyiduna wa maulana muhammadur rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam Dear respected brothers and sisters inshallah this afternoon I'm continue on same topic al isra wal mi'raj blessed journey of the prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam inshallah this afternoon I will try my best to prove that mi'raj was not only dreamly of a spiritual incident but it was physical journey of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant me tawfiq and ability to speak the truth and to all of you listen the truth and then act upon that inshallah. Respected brothers, Alhamdulillah, Mi'raj is unique miracle of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. No other Prophet had given this miracle before the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Prophet Musa alayhi salam requested to Allah Almighty, which has described in part number 9 of Quran al-Muqaddas. He requested to Allah Almighty, قَالَ رَبِّ أَرِنِي أَنْظُرْ إِلَيْكَ O Allah Almighty, I want to see you. Give me opportunity to see. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in reply, لَنْ تَرَانِي Never. Musa, never, you cannot see me. So Musa alayhi salam requested to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed him with conversation. Allah Almighty spoke to him, which has mentioned in part number 3, مَنْ مِنْهُمْ مَنْ كَلَّمَ اللَّهِ Some of them, Allah has conversation with them. Mufassirin has mentioned that مَنْ كَلَّمَ اللَّهِ refers to Prophet Moses alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has conversation with him. So Prophet Moses requested, but Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam was invited.
Subhanallah.
He requested, but Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam was invited by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is difference between Kalimullah and Habibullah. Prophet Moses' title is Kalimullah. Speaker to Allah Almighty, speaker with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, one who has spoke to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's title is Habibullah, beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is difference between speaker with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Kalimullah and Habibullah. So after reading this both conversation, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned about Prophet Moses and about invitation of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. After reading these two verses of the Quran al-Muqaddas, Imam al-Sunnah Sayyiduna Imam Ahmad Raza Khan rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi says in his poetry, Tabarakallah shan teri, tujhi ko zayba hai be niyazi, kahi wo josh lan tarani, kahi taqaze visal ke the. Subhanallah. He has mentioned that O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all praise due to you. Moses insisted to see you. Here you became anxious to see your beloved Sayyidina Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Tabarakallah shan teri, tujhi ko zayba hai beniyazi. Kahin wo josh lan tarani aur kahin taqaze visal ke thi. Allah Almighty want to see the beloved Habib Sayyidina Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. My dear brothers, Alhamdulillah, Mi'raj was physical journey of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. And so many evidence we have here about physical Mi'raj. But first and foremost, I would like to reflect something beautification of Arabic words which has used in this particular verse in Quran al-Muqaddas. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Subhanalladhi asra. Asra. Asra word came from sair. Sair is root word. And asra came from sair. Asra means taking someone with soul and body during the night. Taking someone. And sair means visiting to another places with body and physical. But when the word asra will come from sair, it will give you difference and some emphasized meaning, which means taking someone with soul and body during the night. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned another word, bi'abdihi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has never mentioned bi rasulihi, bi nabiyyihi. And he could mention? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took his rasul, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took his prophet, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took his nabi. But he has never mentioned this. He mentioned bi'abdihi. Ulama of Arabic language has mentioned that abd means slave and servant with body and soul, not only soul, with body and soul. So beautification of this Arabic language which has used in this particular verse tells us that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was took with body and soul from Masjid al-Haram to Masjid al-Aqsa and above seven heaven, which has mentioned in authentic traditions of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Ulama has mentioned that Mi'raj is secret of secret. If it would be dreamly of a spiritual incident, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not mention it in very detail in Quran al-Muqaddas. Because in spirituality, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam always used to be in divine presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As I mentioned in hadith of Bukhari Sharif, Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam says, Tanamu aynaya wa la yanamu qalbi. My eyes sleeping, but my heart not sleeping. Always awaking in remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this hadith tells us that spiritually, beloved of Allah, Sayyidina Muhammadur Rasulullah always used to be in divine presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned this incident in very detail in Quran al-Muqaddas, which means this was not only dreamly incident or spiritual incident, this was physical incident. Physically, Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam went for Mi'raj. My dear respected brothers and sisters, Alhamdulillah, so many evidence we can put forward, but I don't have time much. Mi'raj, one of the great Shaykh, Imam of the Tafsir, Al-Shaykh Tabari rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi said in his book Jami'ul Bayan, Mi'raj was done with body and soul. If a person says that it was a dreamly incident, then this will be an insignificant charge. Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam himself said in Hadith Sharif, Inna Allah ta'ala a'ta Musa al-kalama wa a'tani ar-ruyata liwajhihi wa faddalani bil-maqami. Subhanallah. Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam says, Verily Allah Almighty blessed Moses with privilege of conversation and cherished me with divine vision and exalted me with crown of intercession. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exalted me with crown of intercession and the fountain of Kausar.
Subhanallah.
After that, Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam has mentioned in another hadith sharif, قال رسول الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم رأيت ربه. Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam says, I saw my sublime creator. And Allama Jalaluddin Suyuti rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi says in his Khasa'isul Kubra that this hadith is sahih hadith and authentic tradition of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. There are so many categories in hadith. Some of the hadith are akhbari ahad, weak hadith, weak narration. But this hadith, Allama Jalaluddin Suyuti says in his Khasa'isul Kubra, authentic tradition, sahih tradition of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Another hadith sharif. Inna ibn Umar arsala ila ibn Abbas yas'aluhu hal ra'a Muhammadun rabbahu faqala na'am. Subhanallah. Abdullah ibn Umar radiyallahu ta'ala, companion of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, son of Umar ibn Khattab radiyallahu ta'ala. Abdullah ibn Umar sent a person to Abdullah ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala. Abdullah ibn Abbas is son of Abdullah ibn Abbas is son of Hazrat Abbas ibn Abdul Muttalib. And Abbas ibn Abdul Muttalib is uncle of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. So he sent a person to Ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala in order to ask him, is Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam Suwallah Almighty? Ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala who replied that na'am, yes, Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, su Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear respected brothers and sisters, who is Abdullah ibn Abbas? What do you know about Abdullah ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala? Abdullah ibn Abbas radiyallahu ta'ala is someone that is specifically Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam supplicated and made dua for him by saying, Allahumma allimhu al-kitab wa faqtihhu fid-deen. Narrated in Bukhari, recorded in Bukhari Sharif. Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam supplicated specifically for him, Allahumma allimhu al-kitab, O Allah, allimhu al-kitab, grant knowledge of Quran. Grant knowledge of the tafsir of Quran to Abdullah ibn Abbas and grant him knowledge of jurisprudence of deen. Subhanallah. Specifically, Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam made dua for him and dua accepted, and later on he got title every scholar of tafsir, explainer of the Quran. Before mentioning his name, they mention his title Rasul Mufassirin, the head of explainer of the Quran. Subhanallah. Look at the dua of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Head of the Mufassirun, head of the explainer of the Quran. And how can dua of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam rejected, not accepted? Because when a person will mention his blessed name in the dua is a wasila, that dua acceptable dua. That dua is acceptable dua. And I'm not telling you because of my emotionality. I'm giving you hadith of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Authentic tradition is a proof. Uthman ibn Hunayf radiyallahu ta'ala was blind companion of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Came to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Hadith is very authentic and sahih. Ulama has mentioned in Tirmizi and so many books. Came to Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam and said, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, please supplicate for me, make dua for me. Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam says, go and make dua by saying, Allahumma inni as'aluka bi Muhammadin nabiyyir rahmah. Oh Allah, I am asking you through Muhammad, Prophet of Mercy. I'm asking you through Muhammad, Prophet of Mercy. Oh Allah, heal me and cure me. Subhanallah. Oh Allah, I am asking you through Muhammad, Prophet of Mercy, heal me and cure me. And he supplicated by whatever Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cured him. Subhanallah. Authentic tradition of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. So my dear respected brothers and sisters, here wasila has taught by Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. People asking for wasila, what is the proof of wasila? You know, what is the wasila? Here wasila taught by Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam and tell me, you have to follow what you were taught by Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam or what you were taught by any Maulvi Mufti. You have to follow that deen which taught by Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, which came from Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, which Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam brought from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the revelation and verses of the Quran al-Muqaddas and ahadith of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. My dear respected brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned in Quran al-Muqaddas part number 5, وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ إِذْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ جَاءُكَ فَاسْتَغْفَرُ اللَّهُ وَاسْتَغْفَرَ لَهُمُ الرَّسُولُ لَوَجَدُ اللَّهَ تَوَّابًا رَحِيمًا. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ إِذْ ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ. Surely indeed, when they will transgress themselves, O Messenger of Allah, they have to come to you. When they will transgress themselves, they have to come to you, O Messenger of Allah. فَاسْتَغْفَرُ اللَّهِ, and then they have to seek forgiveness from to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاسْتَغْفَرَ لَهُمُ الرَّسُولُ, and then Messenger of Allah will seek forgiveness for them. لَوَجَدُ اللَّهَ تَوَّابًا رَحِيمًا, then they will find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most forgiving and most merciful. Subhanahu. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, when they will transgress themselves, they don't have any right except to come to you, O Messenger of Allah. Subhanallah. And about hypocrites people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another verse of the Quran al-Muqaddas, which has mentioned in part number 28, those don't want to come, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah says, وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ تَعَالَوْا يَسْتَغْفِرُ لَكُمْ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ لَوَّوْا رُؤُوسَهُمْ وَرَأَيْتَهُمْ يَصُدُّونَ وَهُمْ مُسْتَكْبِرُونَ سَوَاءٌ عَلَيْهِمْ أَسْتَغْفَرْتَ لَهُمْ أَمْ لَمْ تَسْتَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ لَنْ يَغْفِرَ اللَّهُ لَهُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الْفَاسِقِينَ. سبحان الله. Look at the belief, look at the faith, look at the iman. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about hypocrites people, وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ تَعَالَوْا, when it is said to them, تَعَالَوْا, come to Messenger of Allah, he will seek forgiveness for you, come to Messenger of Allah. لَوَّوْا رُؤُوسَهُمْ, they turning their head, and they says, we don't like Muhammad, we don't want to go Muhammad. How can we go Muhammad and we seek, he will seek forgiveness for us and then Allah will forgive us. We don't want to go Muhammad. Allah says about these hypocrites people, وَهُمْ مُسْتَكْبِرُونَ, so arrogant people. So arrogant people. سَوَاءٌ عَلَيْهِمْ أَسْتَغْفَرْتَ لَهُمْ. Oh Messenger of Allah, if you will seek forgiveness for them or not, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never forgive them. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الْفَاسِقِينَ. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't guide the fasiq, immoral persons. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not guide them to a fasiq, immoral persons, misguided people. So my dear respected brothers and sisters, wasira is there. And so many people say, and I was asked by someone as well, that it was in the time of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Still, what about after the death of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam? It was in the time of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam to seek wasila. What about after the death of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam? My dear respected brothers and sisters, first and foremost, who is died and who is alive? This is subject, separate topic inshallah. After the Maghrib Salah, I will speak about this. Who is died and who is alive? This is one of the separate topic and long topic, long subject. So many hours could be speak about this topic. After the Maghrib, inshallah, I will talk. But now I want to give you one narration and then I want to go forward, inshallah. Hadith narrated by Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala, which has mentioned in Ibn Kathir by Ibn Kathir. Ibn Kathir is one of the very famous mufassir, a student of Imam Ibn Taymiyyah. Hadith narrated that a Bedouin, a Arabi, person came to the grave of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam and said, O Messenger of Allah, came to the grave and said, O Messenger of Allah, we commanded that when we transgress on ourselves, we should come to you. We should come to you and you will seek forgiveness for us. And then we will find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most forgiving and most merciful. Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I committed such and such sins. So I came to you because I read the Quran al-Muqaddas and we commanded to come to you, Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After the death of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and who is narrated this hadith? Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala. Who is recorded this hadith? Mufassir ibn Kasir in his tafsir. So Hazrat Ali radiallahu ta'ala, he did not know the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed away. If this was belief of companions that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is not alive anymore, then why he narrated this hadith? Why he narrated this tradition? If this was belief of Mufassirun and Salafi Salihin and Ibn Kasir and so, then why they recorded this hadith in their books? If this was their belief that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is never alive anymore, then why they narrated and why they recorded this hadith? So my dear respected brothers and sisters, Prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, every single person shall taste death, Allah Almighty says in Quran. And directly in another verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refers to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and says, إِنَّكَ مَيْجِتُمْ وَإِنَّهُمْ مَيْجِتُونَ. Oh Prophet, you will die and they will die. Of course, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and all the Prophets of Allah, they tasted the death, you know. But their death is not like our death. Their soul leave the body only for a short while and just after that it return back to their body and still they are alive in their grief. This is belief of Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned about martyrs in Quran. وَلَا تَحْسَبَنَّ الَّذِينَ قُتِلُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أَمْوَاتًا. Even don't think about martyrs that they are died. Allah says in another place, don't say those who sacrifice their life in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that they are died. Don't say this. بَلْ أَحْيَاءٌ وَلَكِنْ لَا تَشْعُرُونَ. They are alive, but you cannot understand their life. They are alive, but you cannot understand their life. This is about martyrs. What do you think about prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? They are alive in their grave. And we are not telling you because of our emotionality and our love with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam beyond the boundaries. No, no, no. There are so many evidence, alhamdulillah. One of the narration which has mentioned in Darmi Sharif, Allama Darmi rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi says, Lamma kana ayyamul hurrati lam yu'adhin fi masjid an-nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam salasan. وَلَمْ يُقَمْ وَلَمْ يَبْرَحْ سَعِيدُ بْنُ الْمُسَيِّبْ مِنَ الْمَسْجِدِ وَكَانَ لَا يَعْرَفُ وَقْتَ الصَّلَاةِ إِلَّا بِحَمْحَمَةٍ يَسْمَعُهَا مِنْ قَبْرِ النَّبِيِّ صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم. سعيد بن مسيب رضي الله تعالى one of the تابعي who met with companions of the Prophet صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم. So when Yazid attacked on Medina and Makkah, when he attacked on Medina, so he made halal the women of Medina for his army. And 3 days and 3 nights, Salah was not prayed in Masjid Nabawi, Masjid of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. And he killed so many companions of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. And so many people of Medina, you know. And he disrespected the people of Medina and city of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. During this incident, Sa'id ibn Musayyib rahmatullahi ta'ala alayhi said that I was in Masjid al-Nabawi, but I was in Masjid al-Nabawi, but I was hidden, you know. I was hidden in the corner and they came to me, but just I was sitting, I was not looking good. So they came to me, but they went back through me, you know, and I was there. And he says that lam yu'ad, he says that وَكَانَ لَا يَعْرِفُ وَقْتَ الصَّلَاةِ إِلَّا بِهَمْهَمَةٍ. وَكَانَ لَا يَعْرِفُ وَقْتَ الصَّلَاةِ إِلَّا بِهَمْهَمَةٍ. He says that azan was not called in masjid. Salah was not prayed with congregation in the masjid. But I used to understand the time of Salah through the voice which was coming from the grave of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. SubhanAllah. I used to understand the time of Salah through the voice which used to come from the grave of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and then I used to read my salah. Subhanallah. So this is belief of companions, this is belief of tabi'in, that prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are alive in their grave. And this is, dear respected brothers, long topic, inshallah, after the maghrib, you will hear much more. Second thing is why people misunderstand that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam did not see Allah Almighty in the Mi'raj. One of the narration which narrated by Hadrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she said that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, I never find them absent from the bed during the night of Mi'raj. So my dear brothers and sisters, this is one narration, but those people who want to criticize the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam's personality, they don't have all of this authentic narration, and they want to pick up this one narration. They don't want to take all of this authentic narration which has in Bukhari, Muslim, Darmi, Baihaqi. But their purpose is to criticize the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So they want to take this one hadith. But I want to give you operation of this one hadith also. Hadrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she came in the nikah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam after the migration. When Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam migrated from Makkah to Medina, when he went to Medina, after that Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, she came to the marriage of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So before that, and Mi'raj, incident of Mi'raj took place when Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was in Makkah before the migration. So before the migration, she was not with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. How can she say that I never find absent the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam from the bed? She was not under the marriage of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam when Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam went for Mi'raj, because Mi'raj incident took place when Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was in Makkah. This is the operation. So many operation I have. Those who want to take, inshallah, they can come to me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in another place, La tudrikul abusar wa huwa yudrikul abusar wa huwa latiful khabir. Eyes cannot comprehend him. So these people say that how Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam saw him, because Allah says eyes cannot comprehend him, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comprehend everything. So my dear brothers and sisters, there are two words in Arabic language. Understanding is something else and reading is something else. Understanding is something else and reading is something else. There are two words, ru'yat and idrak. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that la tudrikul abswar, eyes cannot comprehend him. And we are not telling and we are not claiming that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam comprehended Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who can comprehend? Who can comprehend Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a specific place, in certain place? Nobody can comprehend Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are saying that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not comprehend, but he see, he saw the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is belief of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. This is belief of companions of the Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. This is belief of Salaf al-Salihin. This is belief of Siddiqin. This is belief of Shuhada. And this is belief of Awliya and righteous people of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us ability and understanding the Quran and Hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.